Well, to be perfectly boring about it, you actually translate one page at a time, and you start off and you plod through and you set yourself a task of how many pages. The actual original one on this is printed on foolscap sheets, which I don't think most Americans see now, which is huge size paper. Originally, it was a typewritten manuscript which he dictated and was typed by a lady, as far as we know, called Maria Szelangowska, who was actually arrested with him in Poland subsequently and condemned to death at the same time he was. But her sentence was commuted. But no, I mean, you take it a bit at a time. The story on the whole tells itself. Obviously, with my editor, Terry Tegnasian, we had a lot of discussion about what needs to be explained to a Western audience or a non-Polish audience, because there's a lot of things in it which, you know, he writes for an audience who automatically understood words, terms, concepts. He throws a lot of German terms in, because a lot of the lingua franca in a German concentration camp was German. Everybody spoke German. And if you didn't speak German, tough you know what, because if you couldn't reply in German, you probably died, because they killed you on the spot if you didn't understand it. So there's a lot of German thrown in, and sometimes he takes German words and he declines them as if they were Polish words, and so we had to decide how we would handle that in English. But the text itself was not actually all that difficult. His Polish is straightforward, his Polish is simple. It's very similar to the Polish my father used to use, so I often felt, even though they didn't know each other, they did not overlap in Auschwitz. My father arrived in Auschwitz after Pilecki had in fact escaped, so they never actually met. But their language was very similar and their approach to life was similar, although Pilecki was very religious and my father was not. Because the question was asked actually, I think this evening, whether or not his religion played any part in him choosing to go to the camp. The answer is we don't know, but he certainly does write about his religion at times, and it was clearly very important to him. Well, no, you try to, obviously, you try to, because the important thing, when you translate, you don't translate words. I mean, I know this is a truism, but you translate images. So you sometimes, you know, I mean, the phrase I used today that was read out, you know, I think we got a good kicking or something. I forget what the Polish was, but you have to sometimes slightly transpose. Gosh, well, nice question. No, I think he'd have been pleased. I think he'd have been pleased because, you know, there was never any talk. I didn't sort of formally take over his mantle, but I have sort of kind of since he's died, because he's been dead, 6 years now. No, I think he'd be very pleased because, you know, he felt that what Pilecki had done, as indeed does anyone, you know, was exceptional, and that his story wasn't known. And no, I think he'd be very happy.